All right, people, you know what time of year that is. You know what time of year this is. It is election season, and I'm here to give you all of the dirt. My name is Valencia Dantzler, aka Mother Diva, and I am the official Madam Ambassador of House Music. I'm also a community activist and a freedom fighter. And I have some information to share with you all about this election coming up here in Crook County. Yes, I said Crook County, not Cook County, because y'all know these are some crooked politicians in Cook County, Crook County, Illinois, and Chicago. And I'm going to shut this stuff down right now. Okay? Let me tell you what these dirty, sick, satanic politicians running for office have done this time. Okay? There was a woman named Andrea Reller. She was running for Cook County Assessor. Well, you know, it's a boys' club down there. The two candidates that are men purposely got her kicked off the ballot, citing there was some issues with her signatures. And they got her kicked off the ballot because she's a woman. And let me tell you something. They don't want women being no assessor because a woman gonna get your house together, okay? That's what the assessor does. But let me tell you what she did. She went to court yesterday, y'all, and she got back on the ballot, okay? So I want all my ladies out there, all my people in house music, make sure you punch number 82 for Andrea Reller. Now, I got some information for y'all on early voting, okay? Because early voting opened up today. So early voting is February 21st to March 4th at 16 West Adams. It's 9 to 5 for the rest of this week. Today is February 21st. It's Sunday, 10 to 4. Monday, February 26th through Saturday, March 3rd is 9 to 5, and Sunday, March 4th, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. You can only do early voting at 16 West Adams from today until March 4th. On March 5th, all the way to the election, it's going to be in 51 different places. This election is very important because we need to get some crooks out of office. Now, I'm going to walk you all through the voter's process because a lot of you all are not educated on the process. This is your voter's registration card, okay? I want y'all to take a look at that. And even if you all are watching me from other states around the country, it's very important that you know what this means. A lot of us don't know what this stuff means. So I'm going to start with the precinct. Okay, so I'm gonna put that up so you can see that. Okay, so this is my voter's registration card. Okay, I am in precinct 33 and I am in ward 42. Okay, so the precinct and the ward is basically the community that you live in. In Chicago, there are 50 wards governed by 50 different aldermen. So I'm in ward 42. My alderman is Brendan Rapp. Okay, the precinct is 33, which is like a area. It could be several precincts in one ward. Now, back in the day, they used to have precinct captains. They got rid of that, and I don't even understand why, because it was a volunteer position. But you know, this is Crook County and Chicago. Okay, so now we're gonna move forward. That CONG, that is your congressperson. My congressperson currently is Danny Davis. So you need to look up this information to find out who your congressperson is, okay? Danny Davis is one of the last elders that we have that actually walked with Dr. Martin Luther King. Okay, so he is up for re-election, honey, but he's running for two offices. I'm gonna get in a minute. Now, Danny, you know I love you, honey, but you can't be trying to have two jobs. We ain't gonna go for that. Okay, so moving right along. State legislator, that's what those initials mean. ST period LEG is your state legislator. That is your state senator. My state senator is District 3. Her name is Maddie Hunter. Find out who your state senator is, okay? Moving right along, state representative, that's what ST period REP period means, state representative. I'm in District 5 for the state representative. My state representative is currently Juliana Stratton. Now that seat is up for election because Juliana is running for lieutenant governor with JB Pritzker. I have not decided on who I'm going to vote for state representative, but it will not be Ken Duncan, and I'll get into that. Okay, judicial, those are your judges. It is very important that you vote for the judges. I'm gonna get into that. County board is your commissioner. My current commissioner is Jerry Butler, the Iceman. Y'all remember him back in the day, he had some music out. He's retiring, so I don't know who, I haven't decided on who I'm gonna vote for. I gotta investigate these people. Okay, BOR, I know a lot of y'all are like, what is BOR, Mother Diva? I keep seeing it on my voter's registration card. I don't know what BOR means. BOR means Board of Review, and I'm gonna explain to you what the Board of Review does, okay? But I just wanted you all to make sure that you see all of this, get your voter's registration card out, call down to the Board of Elections commissioners, whatever state you live in, find out who your people are. Get involved, be a part of the process. It is very important that you do that, okay? Now let me get into some of these topics here that we're gonna go over. Now, let me explain what the Board of Review is. The Board of Review is an independent committee that has the power to review assessments made on your property by the assessor. So if you own property, like if you own a house or a building, whatever kind of property that you may own, okay, the assessor assesses the value of your property and they let you know what property taxes and things that you have to pay. You're also eligible for some discounts and things like that based on who you are, how old you are, that kind of thing, okay? If you are not satisfied with the assessor's assessment of your house or your property, you can go before the Board of Review and have them review it. You can challenge it, okay? Now, I don't know if Pat Quinn is still doing this. He might still be doing this, but Pat Quinn is an attorney and he's like a property tax attorney. So let's say the assessor says that you owe a certain amount of property taxes. Well, you can appeal your taxes. You could go to Pat Quinn and say, hey, I want to appeal my taxes, and then they may be able to get you a lower rate. See, I'm going to tell you stuff people ain't going to tell you. Okay, I'm gonna tell you what it is. I'm gonna tell you the truth. These people, no one is gonna go over this information with you. They want you to be an uneducated, uninformed voter. But see, I'm not like that, okay? I ain't got nothing but love for all of y'all, and I want you all to be educated and informed on what to do. Because I'm gonna bust these crooks wide open. These are some dirty, crooked people here that run Illinois and Chicago and Crook County, okay? Let me tell, for those of you that are watching from around the country, let me tell you how crooked it is in Illinois. It is so crooked up here that people won the lottery and the checks bounced. Go look it up. 2012, 2013, people had played the lottery and their checks bounced. And they said it was a computer error. No, it ain't no computer error. Y'all are stealing. Now, I'm going to be real careful with the stuff I'm saying. I mean, I'm not going to be careful. So I'm going to spill all the tea, okay? But I'm going to be careful at how I say it because some of y'all have complained about my language. Sometimes I use too much profanity, as Medea would say. So I'm trying to be careful on how I choose my words, but I am going to say some things about some people, okay? Now, I see that Ms. Delise Williams is on. She's watching. Thank you, Delise, for joining in. Delise Williams is the CEO of Kids Corner, It is a nonprofit organization that helps underprivileged children and children that are abused. Delise is the wife of the king of house music, okay? Barley Jack Master Funk. Bob Fioretti, who is currently running for Cook County Board President, was influential and fought to get Barley Jack Master Funk that street sign that he has down there on 14th in Michigan. Bob used to be the alderman for the second ward, okay? And he was the one who pushed that through. Now, I'm not gonna say no names about who this current Cook County president is, but let me say this. Because see, when you start talking about people and saying their names, you're giving them free publicity. Now, I'm going to give some people some free publicity, but not that person. Let me tell you about our current Cook County board president, okay? Let me just tell you, go to Wikipedia and put our current Cook County board president's name in the Google and Google that person, and you will see what this person's career has been. And if you scroll down, you will see how Dr. Jones, who was in charge of the Cook County morgue, called our current Cook County board president evil, because at the time bodies was piling up over at the morgue because the Cook County is always crying broke. No, Cook County ain't broke. They stealing our money. That's what they doing. They stealing. I'm putting an end to this. I'm tired. People in Cook County, in Chicago, in the state of Illinois, work too hard. You all have promised us stuff. You all have lied to us. But then when an election comes, you want our vote. No, you're not getting our vote. No more. We want you out. It is time for these demons to be put out and kicked out. Now let me also tell you what our current Cook County board president did, okay? They went down to the county morgue in a fur coat to shake the police's hand to offer condolences for this police officer who was innocently killed, okay? How shameful and desperate is that? You're gonna go to the morgue to give your condolences? Let me ask Cook County Board President this question. When Rakia Board was killed by the Chicago Police Department, did you go to the county morgue then? When Laquan McDonald was killed by the Chicago Police, did you go to the county morgue then? Because if you're going to make trips down to the county morgue, president of Cook County, then you need to be going down to the county morgue on a regular basis. Now, unfortunately, Dr. Jones passed away last year. She was in charge of the county morgue, and they have someone new in there, okay? But perhaps they would not have all that disorganization and bodies piled on top of bodies and all this if they had the funding that they needed to take care of those dead bodies down there, okay? And let me tell you something, they ain't no coincidence. These people are demons. Do you all understand how satanic they are? I don't think you all understand how satanic these people are. Why is the phone number to the Cook County Morgue 312-666-0500? The phone number to the morgue in Cook County is 666 because they all a bunch of demons down there. You understand what I'm saying? They got demons for a boss. That's why the number is 666, okay? That ain't no coincidence. They're Satan's relatives. Do you understand that? We don't want Satan's relatives in office no more. We want them out. We want people that are going to come in office and take care of business. Okay? So if you're doing early voting, and if you're voting, period, please support Bob Fioretti. Please vote for him, y'all. He is punch number 82. I'm sorry, punch number 72. Bob Fioretti is number 72 for Cook County Board President, okay? This man fought to have our King of House Music get a street sign, okay? This, listen, how many people do you know, okay, in the city of Chicago? Let's just keep it real. Bob Fioretti is an Italian man, okay? And he fought for one of the chocolatest brothers in the city to get a street sign, okay? Bob Fioretti is doing things in the community. He is trying to help people, okay? He's really trying to help people. And he said, Mother Diva, I promise you, I will try and do my best to do whatever I can to help the house music community. We'll have more events, more festivals. We're going to work together. We're going to do things in the community. I will employ people in the house music community to continue to build in our county. That was what he told me. He told me that. So I want you guys to support him, okay? Because you know these crooked politicians, they don't care about what we're trying to do. House music has healed people, okay? People who are sick, people who have had cancer, people who have mental illness. The music has saved so many people's lives. And let me tell you guys something. I'm having 3 more events at Daily Plaza. April 16th is my 4-year anniversary. June 22nd and July 17th. Now, Daily Plaza is right across the street, okay, from the Board of Elections building where the current president of the Cook County works in that building, okay? So I'm just letting y'all know, because if they try to sabotage me, because I'm calling them out, because one time they came over there and said the music was too loud. Okay, how you gonna come over to my event? You cross the street in another building. Now, first of all, let me say this. Y'all know the speaker system at Daily Plaza ain't that great, okay? Some of y'all DJs and complain about that. I ain't got no control over the speaker system at Daily Plaza. It's gotten better over the years. They got some better speakers now. They got the speakers with the bass bottoms now. Those were better than the ones when we first started in 2014, okay? But y'all know it ain't that bad. They said they can hear the music in the building across the street and gonna say, can we turn the music down? How about can you turn our taxes down? How about that? Okay? Because the people of Cook County pay enough in taxes. And how dare you say, oh, well, if we gotta cancel the soda pop tax, we gonna have to take the money from somewhere else. No, you all need to work with us. We are the people of Cook County. Now, if you were smart, you would have came out and said, look, people, we're trying to balance the budget. We ain't got no money. There's folks up in here stealing. So we got to balance it out and fix it. So what we need to do, we need your cooperation. Okay? We're going to raise the sugar tax 50 cents. And we're going to do that for about 18 months. And if you all are willing to participate and help with us with this, we'll give you some kind of incentive. We'll do something for you. You got to work with the people. You cannot impose stuff on us and expect us to vote for you. You got to talk to us. You got to make us feel like we are part of the process. If you don't make us feel that way, we won't kick you out of office. Simple as that. People are tired of this. This makes no sense. Let me tell you something, y'all. Let me explain something to you. I want you all to be educated, okay? And the stuff that I'm telling you, they can kill me for this. I am risking my life and my career to save someone else. And I'm telling you right now, if y'all find me chopped up in the Chicago River with this house around my neck, y'all know who did it. It was either them people at the Grammys or these evil mobster politicians here in Illinois. Okay, I'm just letting people know what's going on. Now, let me show you something. Because you got to do your research. This is the 2018 candidate's guide for the state of Illinois. You see that? Okay. the first page. It's called a preface. You see that? That's the preface. I'm gonna read what it says. Now, this is the stupidest crap that you ever want to hear about in your life. Check this out. Legal information contained in this guide is not binding and should not be construed as sufficient argument in response to an objection to any candidate's nomination paper. The State Board of Elections recommends that all prospective candidates consult with a competent legal counsel when preparing their nomination papers. Now, let me explain. This guide is for people who want to run for office. If you want to run for office in Illinois, or Cook County, the city of Chicago, whatever it is, if you want to run for office, you got this guide. But it's saying that the guide is not considered binding with the legal information in it. Then why you put it in there? Why you put it in there in the first place if it's not binding to object to somebody's candidacy papers? What kind of backwards Billie Jean bull crap is this? How you gonna put this in here? So basically what you saying is everything in this don't even matter. That's ridiculous. Let me tell you what else you don't know. Because I want y'all to be educated when the next election come around. This is stuff that they don't tell you. Let's say you sign your signature for somebody to get on the ballot. If you change your mind, you can go down to the Board of Elections and say, hey, I signed for Jane Doe to be on the ballot, but I changed my mind. I want my signature striked from that petition. And you can fill out some paperwork and they'll strike your signature. I wanted to let y'all know that, okay? Because sometimes you be under pressure. People putting stuff in your face. Can you sign for me? Can you sign for me? You know, I'm trying to get on the ballot. I don't even know you. Let me do some research on you. You got a bio, a resume, a website. They're trying to stick stuff in your face and don't even give you a business card half the time. Let me look you up. Let me investigate you before I sign my name. Because I'm going to tell you why, people. Your signature is very important. Do you know what these dirty satanic people are doing with your signatures? Let me tell you, if you don't believe me, call down there and find out. Anybody can go down to the Board of Elections and ask to review a candidate's nomination papers and their signatures. And guess what? They can make copies of the signatures and walk out of that office with them. That is unacceptable. And you wonder why we got all of this white collar crime and signature fraud. Because they letting people take our signatures out of the office. They got your name, address, and your signature. So it could be a serial killer. Could be coming to your house to shoot you up. Now see, let me explain the difference. Because if you are registered to vote, your name and address is going to be on the voters list for that area. So candidates can go door to door to try to get your signature. When you run for office, see, I learned all this when I ran for alderman. I ran for alderman for the 4th Ward. That's how I learned all this stuff back in 2010. So they have what you call, they have an area map, and it has all the registered voters' name and addresses on it, okay? Which that's not a problem. That's not a problem for me because it ain't a signature. It's different, okay? If you register to vote, just like your ID, your social security number, you know your information is in the system. There is something in the United States called the Freedom of Information Act. That means anybody can go and get anybody's information because it's called the Freedom of Information Act, okay? So what happens is, let's say you're running for office and you need 1,000 signatures. So you go down to the Board of Elections or wherever you go, the county, the city, wherever you're running, and you get that list so you can go door to door and get you a signature because those signatures may be guaranteed Because you already know they registered voters because you got the list, as opposed to standing in front of the Walgreens collecting signatures because you don't know those people. You don't know if they registered to vote. They can tell you, yeah, I'm registered to vote. They could be lying. Okay? So that's the difference. One is printed name and address. The other one is your signature, name and address, in your handwriting. That's the problem. The election code laws need to be changed. And this is why I am not voting for Ken Duncan no more. I will not, he will not get my vote. Ken, I don't care how mad you get at me. I've been voting for Ken Duncan since 2006. He's a house head, and I used to vote for him. But I gave him a proposal in 2011 that was amazing. It was an amazing proposal for the laws to be changed for the election code process. And I said, Ken, you need to get this to the Illinois state legislator. You need to sponsor this. He never responded. He never called me back. I'm seeing him at house parties, you know, Jack in the House and dancing. I'm like, Ken, he's like, Mother Diva, call me on Monday. You know, he just out there dancing and carrying on. But yet you want our vote. No, Ken, You done away with it. I'm through with that. I'm not fooling with you no more. That's the end of that. So when Juliana Stratton was running, I voted for her. And when I saw Ken at the Black Women's Expo, I told him I voted for Juliana because you don't return phone calls, you don't return emails. And let me tell you something, people who running for office or you up for re-election, you need to get back to your constituents, okay? I'm calling out somebody else. Susanna Mendoza, I'm calling you out, Susanna. This is me and Susanna Mendoza. Susanna Mendoza is our current state controller. In 2016, I went over to Senator Toy Hutchinson's office, and I was making phone calls to get people to come out. I volunteered, okay? I was making phone calls to get people to come out to vote for Tammy Duckworth, who is now our U.S. Senator. Who I love, Tammy Duckworth. To me, Tammy Duckworth can do no wrong, and I'm gonna tell you why. And Paul Christopher Fortner is on. Thank you for supporting us and coming in today, Chris. Tammy Duckworth was in the military. She fought for this country, and she lost the use of her legs. Okay. And anybody that fought for this country and lost the use of their legs, but is still in office trying to fight for justice and fight for the rights of the people, will always have my support. And she pregnant again at 49. Go ahead, Miss Tammy. So I'm making phone calls trying to get people to come out and vote for Tammy Duckworth and Susanna Mendoza. Okay. I met Susanna Mendoza. I said, I'm a talk show host, and I'm the Madam Ambassador of House Music. I have House Music DJ sets at Daily Flats. I said, but I would love, to do something with you. And she said, I would love to do something with you. Let my office know. Let me know when you're having some more events. Let's do something together. This is what Susanna Mendoza told me in person when we took this picture together. In case y'all tuning in, okay. Now let me tell you what the state controller does. Because a lot of y'all don't know what the state controller does. Okay. This is what the controller, this is the duties, these are the duties of the controller, okay? They maintain the central fiscal accounts of the state, order payments into and out of the funds held by the treasurer of Illinois. In accordance with this duty, the controller signs paychecks, or grants approval to electronic payments made by the state to its employees and creditors. The controller is also charged by Illinois statute with certain additional duties. In particular, the controller regulates cemeteries under the Cemetery Care Act and is charged with fiduciary protection of cemetery care funds used for the care and maintenance of Illinois grave sites. So that is what the state controller does. Okay. Well, this is what I was trying to do. I was trying to have a house music health fair at the state of Illinois built. And in order for me to do that without it costing me an arm and a leg, if I had partnered with the state controller or a state legislator, like the state senator or the state representative, I could get the floor at no cost, but I would have to pay the state police to police the event, okay? So I emailed Susana Mendoza's office, and this is what I said. I said, my name is Valencia Dantzler, AKA Mother Diva. I'm a talk show host, producer, Madam Ambassador of House Music. My company's mission is to inform and educate the community both on a level, local level and global level regarding sustainable living, health and wellness throughout entertainment and social change. I received an email below to come out and support Comptroller Mendoza. First of all, when I ran into her in 2016, I was a volunteer in State Senator Toy Hutchinson's office and made phone calls to get out the vote for Mendoza and Duckworth. When we met, our picture is attached. She personally told me she was interested in partnering me for my house music events. I produce at Daily Plaza. I was planning a house music event at Daily Plaza, and I was trying to make it a community appreciation event with her name on it, and she would have been the keynote speaker. The only way to get the James Thompson Center for free is to have a state politician to book it. This would be great publicity for both of us. Comptroller Mendoza personally told me to stay in contact with her about these opportunities. So now she is in office due to in part to my contribution. But when I needed her, I was rejected. I submitted the information and request to her office for this event and received the below email. This is the email they sent me. Hello, Mother Diva. Wow, sounds like a very fun event. But unfortunately, Comptroller Mendoza is unable to assist in getting this set up. We are sorry if you were given the false impression that our office has the ability to help set up events here at the James Thompson Center. But honestly, Wilma is the correct contact to be working with. Once you get on a schedule, we'd love to come down and enjoy the music. Keep us in the loop. Thanks again, Amanda. Amanda is Prentice is the secretary to Susana, Comptroller Susana Mendoza. So I'm gonna let y'all see that email at the bottom there. See. Now, here's the issue that I'm having. You rejected me. You said that I was given the wrong impression. No, I was not given the wrong impression, okay? I've known Wilma for years, and I ain't talking about Wilma Flintstone. I'm talking about Wilma Wilborn, who works at the James Thompson Center, okay? And Wilma told me what it was. Wilma said, Mother Diva, we have to charge you for the space unless you get a state politician, and it's their event, then you can get it for free, okay? I'm trying to have something special for the community. There are people out here that have diabetes, high blood pressure, blood clots, cancer, and I was trying to have it was called a house music health and wellness fair, where it was going to have vendor tables of different health companies. We were going to have holistic health. We're going to have the chair massager and all these different things. It was going to be on a Saturday from noon to 5. I was going to have all these DJs come and spin, and it'd be about health and house music. I'm trying to do something to help the community, to help our health. You know, they want to increase the sugar tax and put a sugar tax on the community because they say, well, if we raise the taxes, then maybe people won't buy stuff that's not bad, that's bad for them. But I'm trying to have a house music health fair and teach people how they can heal themselves holistically. I have lost 103 pounds with no drugs. You understand? I used all the herbs that the Creator put in the earth that my holistic doctors told me to use to lose this weight. I used to weigh 335 pounds. Okay, look at me. You see how much weight I've lost? I look good, honey. Look at all that. You understand? I am trying to teach people how to stay healthy in house music. We have lost too many DJs, too many music producers. They dropping dead left and right. We lost Spanky last year. We lost Frankie Knuckles. We're losing too many people in our industry. And then I get rejected and treated like this by people I done voted in office and then told other people to get voted in, to vote for these people. Now, Susanna, let me say this to you, because maybe it ain't you. Maybe it's your staff, okay? Maybe it's your staff, because I made a video about Quincy Jones, trying to get Quincy Jones up here to get a street sign for him, and it was his staff, and I had to curse the staff out. So if this your staff, you need to fire your staff, Susanna, because I'm telling you right now, if I don't get justice, if I don't get a phone call, an apology, or we work something out, I'm not voting for you. And you know what? Maybe you don't care because you're the only one on the ballot. So then that means, you know, you're going to win anyway. But see, here's the issue that I'm having. Now, they told me she couldn't help me, but then they is sending me emails, y'all, for her fundraising. Why is she fundraising now? According to published reports, her term is 4 years. She was put in office in 2016. So that means her term is up in 2020. So you fundraising now? Well, hey, maybe that's, you need to fundraise now so you can stack your dollars 2 years early, so when time comes, you have the money to campaign. If you saving up for it, hey, I can't say nothing about that. We teach people to save up for college and save for a rainy day, okay? My issue is not being invited to the fundraisers for support. My issue is when I needed you, I was rejected. That's my issue, Controller Susanna Mendoza, okay? Now we're gonna move on, because I got other stuff that I wanna talk about. Okay. Danny Davis is running for Congress and he's running for committee. Now, Danny, listen, you can't have two jobs. Now, you're going to have to pick one, okay? And I'm telling you right now, I'm seriously considering voting for the other guy for Congress because I think you need to retire, okay? This commitment, I might give you that. That's a cute little thing that you can have in your retirement while you go play golf and reminisce about the good old days. So I may consider that. I already told y'all Ken Duncan is not getting my vote. I'm in his district. Everybody is in a different district, okay? One of the things that I want to talk to you guys about is voting for the judges. A lot of y'all do not vote for the judges. You got to vote for these judges. Some of y'all are like, well, Mother Diva, we don't know who the judges are. Guess what? They know who you are when you get in front of them when you done something wrong. They done reviewed you. So when you stand before that judge, they know who you are. So guess what? You better go do a detailed investigation on these judges and go look them up. And I'm going to tell you why. You will stand before a judge in your lifetime before you stand before a president, a senator, a congressperson, a state representative, a mayor, an alderman, a commissioner, or whoever. You're going to stand before a judge, even if it's just for a traffic ticket, even if it's you a witness in a case. You're going to stand before a judge sometime in your lifetime. Hallelujah. That's just the way it is, okay? Let me tell you what happened last year. DJ Rocky Jones was scheduled to spin for me last year. He had to come down a little late because he was up in Daly Plaza. He had a court case. And when he came down to spin, the judge came down too. And we said it on the microphone. The judge was like, I didn't know he was spinning out here today. And I said, and the judge came down and enjoyed the music, and he had just stood before that judge. So it's very important that you vote for the judge. Now, I'm going to tell you one judge that's in my, I'm in the 8th 8th Sub-Circuit. When you, this is what you guys need to do. Go to ChicagoElections.com or whatever city that you're in Illinois, and get your sample ballot. Your sample ballot has a list of everybody on the ballot that you're going to be voting for. And then start investigating. Just Google these judges. Look them up. It's very important, because a judge has the power to put you away forever, to put you away for a short time, or to give you probation, give you a slap on the wrist, and make you pay a fine. The judges are the ones who swear in the president, the senators, the congress people, the mayor. Okay? A judge got more power than all of them, baby. Go read your Bible. Go read your Bible. It's in the Bible. Go read your Bible. You got to go back and read the Bible. See? You got to read the Old Testament. When they was begging and begging for a king, they had judges before the king came along. See? The judges have more power than anything. So you all start investigating them judges. I'm telling you, these people will not tell you what I'm telling you, y'all. I'm telling you, I am trying to make sure that you are educated and informed voters, okay? Y'all already know what to do, house music community. We got to get the current Cook County Board President out and get Bob Fioretti in. So that is punch number 72, okay? Bob is going to be the man to take care of us, okay? Punch number 72 for Bob Fioretti. Punch number 82 for Andrea Riley. Now, see, I want to tell y'all something, because I also want you all to do some research and some investigations on the people that's in office now that's up for re-election. See who they connected to. Because if you do some research, you will find, okay, that the current Cook County Board President is the one that got the current Cook County Assessor in, okay, which that person is up for re-election. I'm not going to say no names, okay? I'm not going to say no names with that. The only name that I'm going to say is Andrea Riley. Look her up. Now, let me tell you something. I've been investigating people for a long time, and I ain't never seen nobody like this one. This woman is not a politician. She is a person, okay? Her background is in property taxes and tax and 1040s and all that good stuff, and she know all that stuff, honey. And she has helped so many people in the community. She's reasonable. Let me tell you why I'm supporting this woman. It's not just because she's a woman, but it's because the way she ran for office. Let me tell you what these dirty candidates do. When you run for office, you may be running on a ticket with 10 other people that want that same seat. So what they do is they go through your nomination papers and your signatures to find a reason to kick you off the ballot. Because the more people that get kicked off the ballot, the less competition they have. Their main goal is to get rid of you, okay? Because if I get rid of you, then I don't have to face you in a debate. And it's less money for me to spend. It's less trouble. So let me figure out how to get rid of my opponents, okay? Andrea Riley just ran for office. She just filed her papers, she got her signatures, and she's still working her regular job. She didn't try to get the other candidates kicked off the ballot, because she's not a coward, okay? Anybody that's running for office, I'm gonna tell all of y'all right now, if you are digging into a person's background to try to get them kicked off a ballot, you are a punk and you a coward and you're insecure and you're this small. And y'all know what I mean, okay? Because there's two other men running on that ticket for Cook County Assessor. And I say they're this small. You have to be a small-minded individual to try to get somebody kicked off the ballot, because you don't have, might as well say, you don't have the balls to face them off with them. You ain't strong enough. You insecure. Okay? But since you did that to her because she's a woman and you two boys wanted to just battle it out and you wanted to get the girl out of the way, well, I'm going to use that to make sure she wins this election, okay? Because let's take a poll. Since men have been saying it since the beginning of time that women can keep house really good, who would you rather be taking care of your house taxes, a man or a woman, okay? Women know how to take care of their house, you see? We don't want anyone in office that's small. We want someone in office that will make a huge impact on the community. And Andrea Rella is the lady to do that. She will clean up our house. She will clean up our property. What I mean by that is, she will make sure that we're getting fair assessments on our house and our property. So we don't necessarily have to go before the Board of Review because she's a fair and just person. Okay, and I want you to think about that. She ain't no career politician. She's a regular everyday person that helps the community. We don't need any more politicians in office. What we need is people to run our government. Hardworking, everyday people who can identify and understand what the citizens of Crook County and Chicago and the state of Illinois are going through. Okay? Let's go back to this Crook County soda tax. Now, the soda tax didn't affect me. As y'all can, like I said, I lost a lot of weight. I don't drink pop. I don't drink all that sugary juice. I drink water and apple cider. Okay, that's what I drink. So it didn't affect me. Okay, but the bottom line is, when that tax was imposed on us, you know what it did? It ran everybody over to Indiana. So Indiana got all of our money because people didn't want to spend all of that money on sugar soda tax or whatever you want to call it. First of all, let's go back to the governor imposing a junk food tax. Now, I talked to former Governor Quinn on the phone the other day because I said, Governor Quinn, these men have tried to railroad Andrea to get her kicked off the ballot. We need your support. He said, Mother D, this is what Governor Pat Quinn, he used to be the governor of Illinois, this is what he told me. If y'all don't believe me, go on my Facebook page and look through my pictures. You'll see a picture of me and Governor Quinn when he came to speak at my house music event last year on May 31st. Governor Quinn has been involved in a project called Take Charge Chicago. This is the only reason I let him come down there, okay? The only reason I let Governor Quinn come down there is because Take Charge Chicago is trying to get a law passed in the city of Chicago to put term limits on the office of the mayor, where a mayor can only be in office 8 years. And then after that, we give someone else a chance to run the city. I mean, a mayor should not be a mayor for 99 years. That's not fair. Let someone else come in and help our city and do something unique and creative and build our city. Give others a chance, okay? So I had appreciated that. So I let him come down to get his signature, okay? He gave me $20. I asked for a sponsorship. Governor Quinn gave me $20. I guess I should have been grateful because he didn't have to give me nothing. So anyway, when I talked to him yesterday, he said, Mother Diva, I'm running for Attorney General. I love Andrea. She's been my friend 35 years. I do support her, but I can't come out publicly behind her right now because my focus is on my own campaign. And this is what he told me, I swear to y'all. He said, but Mother Diva, he said, if you are helping Andrea the way you helped Dorothy Brown get reelected, she gonna be just fine. And he made me feel so good when he said that. And so I said, okay, I respect that. I called Dorothy Brown. And let me tell you something about Dorothy Brown. These people are about divide and conquer, okay? I contributed to Dorothy Brown's re-election campaign. You see, she got re-elected. Dorothy Brown will tell you that. I helped her tremendously. I'm not going to stand here and say it was all me, because it wasn't all me. It was a team of us, okay, that helped Dorothy Brown get reelected. When I tell you Ms. Dorothy Brown had favor with the Holy Spirit, the punky Democrats, they rejected her. They denounced her. She wasn't even backed or supported by her own party, and she still got reelected. How you like that? Because if the Holy Spirit, which is Yahshua, the Holy Spirit, y'all call him Jesus, but his name is Yahshua. If he be for you, no one can be against you. And she got reelected. I called her, I said, Dorothy, I said, listen, they trying to railroad Andrea. She said, Mother Diva, let me explain something to you. I am the clerk of the Circuit Court of Cook County. I cannot publicly endorse no candidate, because when these candidates feel like they are have been unfairly done by the Board of Elections, they appeal it in court. My name and my signature and my stamp is on every single court document in Cook County. So I cannot come out publicly for no candidate. Okay? Now, that's her job. She could get in trouble for that. Let me tell y'all something about the Honorable Clerk of the Circuit Court of Cook County, Ms. Dorothy Brown. She's unbalked and unbossed. And let me tell you why people keep messing with her. Because these crooked mobsters, that's Satan's relatives, they cannot buy her off to tamper with court records. She refuses to do that. She loves her job, she loves serving the community, and she's not going to do anything illegal. And when you get somebody in office that is honest, that is respectable, that has integrity, the crooked people, the lobbyists, and all the big wigs that got money, that want to throw some money at you, they can't do nothing with you. So you know what they do? They try to destroy your character. They try to bring you down in the media. They go after people in your office and attack the people in your office. They go after your family. They'll even have somebody you know arrested. Because they dirty like that, okay? They're dirty, satanic people. You understand? This is what these people do. But the Holy Spirit has put a shield around us to protect us in this fight. And this is why I'm making this video, because change is coming. Look at everything that's happened within the last year. The Holy Spirit has been exposing everybody's dirt. All this sexual harassment, sexual misconduct, sexual assault, all this stuff is coming out. Fires and earthquakes and famines. And honey, you better read the Bible. It's Matthew, the 24th chapter. Okay? So, Andrea, let me tell you this, baby. I'm asking all my female DJs, all my ladies that are executives of corporations in Cook County, all of you hardworking women out there that have families, that own property, that have wonderful homes and houses, please vote for Andrea Rolla to be our next Cook County assessor. It is time for a woman to truly run the house. Hallelujah. Punch number 82. For Andrea Rolla, punch number 72 for Bob Fioretti. Now, let me see if I got anything else that I need to go over. Let me see. I went over all of this. Okay, I'm going to give you guys the voting dates again. So, you can early vote February 21st, March 4th, through March 4th at 16 West Adams. From 9 to 5, Sunday is 10 to 4, Monday, February 26th, through Saturday, March 3rd is 9 to 5, Sunday, March 4th, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Go to ChicagoElections.com, Get your sample ballot. Start investigating these people. I haven't decided on who I'm gonna vote for the governor. Okay, and let me say to the Kennedy person, the Kennedy guy that's running, baby, let me tell you something. A lot of people are afraid to vote for you because they think you're gonna get assassinated or something because of, you know, your family got a history of that. And I try to tell people, if you go look up the Kennedys that are still in public office, not all of the Kennedys have been shot at. So, you know, y'all got to stop that. I don't know, Chris, if I'm gonna vote for you or not. I have to do some more research. You know, I just can't decide on who I'm gonna vote for the governor. And listen, let me tell y'all something. Just because you see people's TV commercials over and over and over and over and over and over and over again doesn't necessarily mean you need to vote for those people. Okay? Now, if you see me in the commercial, you need to vote for those people. Okay, because I ain't gonna be in no politician's commercial unless I done a detailed investigation to make sure they right. Okay, and let me tell you something. If I find out they ain't right, they ain't gonna get reelected. Cause let me tell you something. Every politician that I have supported in their campaign has won. I do not mess with losers. Okay, I'm a winner. And I don't mess with losing. Now, let me tell you what happened. I'm going to go back. I don't know if y'all remember Scott Lee Cohen. Scott Lee Cohen ran for lieutenant governor. I wrote a speech for Scott Lee Cohen. I don't know if Scott Lee Cohen had used my speech, but it could have inspired him. Okay. He ran on an independent ticket. And he won. And you know what happened? And you know, Governor Quinn, I love you. But you did do this, and people can go back and look at the news footage. Governor Quinn and Jesse White got on a press conference, and they asked Scott Lee Cohen to step down because of some alleged domestic violence situation he had with his wife or girlfriend or whatever. And so they requested that he step down. I was mad as hell. I was like, he should not do that. He won fair and square. Okay, now the reason I want y'all to go and investigate this and look at this situation is because if you go and look at the your sample ballot and you see who's running for governor, they have the lieutenant governor running with them. That was because Scott Lee Cohen made history. He ran for lieutenant governor on an independent ticket and he won. And if he would have not stepped down, Pat Quinn would have had to accept him as lieutenant governor. Well, guess what these crooked, satanic politicians in the Illinois General Assembly did? They changed the law. They changed the election law, y'all. Yes, they did. Go down to Springfield. They changed the law. Now the law says if you're going to run for office, it's got to be two people that's running for, like, the captain and the co-captain. So a person that's running for governor, the lieutenant governor has to run with them. That was because of what happened with Scott Lee Cohen. And Scott got angry and he stepped down and ran against Quinn and lost. Okay, because you know Quinn was gonna win. I mean, you know, Quinn had that kind of power. So the point is, go to the state of Illinois' website or go down to the state building and get that election code law book and start reading that book or study it online. I want y'all to be educated. It is time to get educated, do our research, and find out what's going on. These people, I'm telling you, Crook County, Chicago, Illinois has been, it just ran by mobsters. They try to intimidate people, bully people. You're not gonna bully us. We're not going for this stuff no more. We ain't going for this crap no more, okay? We're gonna put you out of office. Our votes mean something. Don't you let nobody tell you your vote don't mean anything, okay? Your vote means something if you are an educated and informed voter. Now, let me tell you something. The Chicago Board of Elections, they have meetings that are open to the public. Go to those meetings. Voice your feelings. You are a registered voter. You are a citizen in the city of Chicago and Cook County and a resident of the state of Illinois and whatever other county you live in. Say how you feel. We pay taxes. We pay taxes. We have a right to say how we feel. We have a right to put you out of office. We are tired of your crap. We're tired of you making promises and not keeping them. We're tired of you lying to us. We go out of our way to help you get in office, and then you reject us and abandon us? Shame on you. You're a generation of vipers. And I plead the blood of Yahshua, the Holy Spirit, on all of y'all. It is time for a change. It is time for you all to start being fair to people. Stop trying to get people kicked off the ballot. That ain't no fair race. If you had all the confidence, listen, if I'm running for office, let me tell you something, honey. I'm confident in myself because the Holy Spirit is my husband. I don't have to do nothing to try to get you kicked off the ballot because I already know that I have won the election. The race is all over, okay? Because guess what? I'm shutting it down. Sophia Home now, Sophia Home. And I'm going to shut it down because I'm the president, the CEO, the governor, and the mayor of life. That's who I am, okay? And I'm going to shut all you dirty satanic people down. The doggone shame, the way you carry on. And what our Cook County Board President did at that morgue was horrific. How dare you go over there and shake those police officers' hands to give their condolences at a morgue? You did that just to get votes. I was shocked and appalled. And let me tell you something. If you try for any reason to sabotage my events and try to stop my events, you're going to have to deal with my sponsors. So I would suggest you go about your business. Why don't you retire and resign before this election is over? Go work for Trump. Go to another county. Get out of the state. Go somewhere else. Because you have completely messed up your office. And the way you treated Dr. Jones, that woman died last year of cancer. She had bodies on top of bodies on top of bodies. Go look it up, y'all. Dr. Jones said our current Cook County Board President was evil. All these people are evil. Call the county morgue. Call the county morgue. The phone number to the Cook County morgue is 312-666-0500. Why the county morgue phone number 666? Because they're satanic and demons. That's why. The people who run this whole entire city. It's ridiculous. There's some good people in office. But the bad is outweighing the good. You gotta stop stealing from us. Where is the lottery money? The lottery money is supposed to go to the schools. What are you doing with it? You stealing. And let me tell y'all something. You dirty, satanic politicians and you candidates that's running, that trying to get people kicked off the ballot because you crooked too. You gonna be out of this body a lot longer than you in it. You better prepare for eternal life, peace, and joy. If you want heaven, you better get right with Yahweh our Elohim. But if you keep going the way you're going, your soul gonna be eternally damned. This is supposed to be about love. We are family here in Cook County, in Chicago. House music, house, what is your house, your home? This is about love. We should be loving each other, helping each other, being in unity, being a family. We put y'all in office. We vote for y'all. And what do? You raise our taxes. You cut jobs. You treat us like we're nothing. We're not going to take it no more. Get out, Satan. And take your relatives with you. Hallelujah and goodbye.